what do you want to see done with the Measure U money?
I think a lot of people see me jumping on the mayor's desk, and I think they don't pay attention to the exact words that I said after that. The rent is too high, the gang banging has to stop, and the poverty is uncontrollable. So if we could tackle these issues when it comes to affordable housing, gang relations, trying to figure out the problem and how we can help with that, and also the poverty and tackling the homelessness and the divide and the wealth gap, especially here in Meadowview, there's not too many resources. We could just put more light on these issues. Most importantly, the poverty, you know, that I see here. And I'm not just talking about the South, I'm talking about Del Paso Heights as well. To have more youth initiative programs, to have more case managers. I want to see a lot of small business grants come here to the Meadowview and Del Paso Heights area. You know, not just the Midtown and the Oak Park section. I want to see everybody get helped and everybody have the same opportunities. That's why I think, that's where I come in when it comes to making sure these people that are having this money and distributing this money are being held accountable.
There are a diverse slate of voices who are giving input. I mean, are you?
Yes. I think we need that, and we don't need the same people in power, the same systems in place. You know, we need to switch things up and diversify things. I think that's the only way you get things done. Everyone needs to have a voice. You know, I'm the voice of my brother, Stephon Clark. You know, he has no voice, he's voiceless now, so I get to be his voice. But also, through this, I get to be a voice for my community and the people that I live around and are affected by the same things my brother and I was affected by. So I think that's big, and not having the same people that's been in power and making the same decisions over and over and over. And I know there'll be another committee as well to oversee the Measure U funds. So I think to have multiple oversight commissions and it's great. It's a great thing to have. I'm glad the mayor and Larry Carr reached out to me. You know, Larry Carr, great man, and I'm grateful for him giving me this opportunity to represent my community. You know, like I said, I do want to see a lot. I want to see programs like the Freedom School be enacted here. You know, more. You know, I want to see a lot of change. You know, there's a lot of open space here that needs to be used in the Meadowview community. And I would like to see Meadowview be one of those places where when you come out of town, you come visit. You don't just come visit downtown. You just don't come visit the Raley's Field. And, you know, you might want to stop by and see something in Meadowview you haven't seen before. Look, I used to do security before this. And my job as a security guard was to observe and report. I'm doing the same thing here. I'm observing what's going on, and I'm reporting to my people. You know what I mean? I'm reporting to the people that I'm in place with. You know, like, this is what we have, this is what we're dealing with, and this is what we need to do. You know, so I think this is a big opportunity and a great opportunity for people who don't feel like they have a voice to lean on and pay attention to. You know, because at the end of the day, I represent my people here. So I am the voice for a lot of these people who think they don't have a voice. And I want them to understand that. You know, I'm not just representing me as I sit on this table. I want to hear your concerns. And I will be having focus groups in the near future to talk about those needs. People in these under-resourced, undeveloped parts of Sacramento, such as Del Paso Heights in the Meadowview community, they feel like they're left out of a lot of these deals and a lot of these decisions that are being made at City Hall. They don't trust City Hall. A lot of people that I talked to really didn't support Meadowview because they don't trust City Hall with the money that will be raised. And me being on this accountability commission puts a little bit of trust back in City Hall, not just by the people who are living in these areas, but also by people who have nothing to do with politics at all. The money shouldn't just go to Meadowview, but I feel like the money should be distributed equally. This is a lot of money we're talking about here. This is a lot of money, so a lot of resources should be. You know, I know a lot of people live in their bubble. They don't get to see a lot of these things. A lot of people in Sacramento that don't live in Sacramento probably have never even been to Meadowview. So I just want people to expand their horizons, and I want people to know that there's two sides of the tracks, and I live on the other side of the track. And even though I live on that, even though I still see the problems and the issues. I still see the problems and issues that go on in Midtown. I still see, I pay attention to everything that's going on in Oak Park area. But the goal of the Measure U, from what I was told, was to make Sacramento a more inclusive modern society. And however I could do to help that and be a part of that is what I plan on doing.
Cool. Awesome.
Yes, ma'am.
Time.
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
all right.
Definitely.